Welcome back. I'm Jesper Pedersen from KDAB. We are in the middle, well, towards the end, of programming with Qt and QML. We're currently down in the machine room looking at signals and slots. We saw the concept in the previous video, but previous plus one video. In the previous one, we saw the macro-based and the pointer-to-member function connect. And now we're going to see how to connect signals to Lambda expressions. Actually, there are three different ways that we can connect our signals using function objects. We can do that to Lambda functions as I just said. We can do that using functors. Do you even know what a functor is? And we can use that with standard functions. Let's see the code for this. What you're looking at here on the slide is connecting a signal to a Lambda expression. Please do hang in there. There are a few caveats when we talk about connecting a signal to a Lambda expression. Do not just run away and say, hey, cool, I'm never going to connect my signals to slots anymore, because you're likely not going to be very successful down that route. So let's see. To connect the signal to a Lambda expression, I have a widget Q push button here again. It is connected, so it takes three parameters, connects who is emitting the signal, which signal, so that's a pressed signal, and then which slot is just replaced by a Lambda expression. So here we have a Lambda expression. What we have inside the square bracket is the closure, where I'm ticking this button so that I can use it in this second part, which is the body of my Lambda expression. And this is simply just regular Qt widget code for setting the text of a push button. Let's try it in Qt Creator so that we can see what it looks like. Actually, the example that I got here is a slightly more complex example, simply because that it's showing you also this slider to the spin box over here and setting up the layout. So that's what we have up until this line here. So the line that we have here behind the dialog box says connect my line edits text change signal to lock string lock. Now, what is lock string? Well, that's our first example. This is a functor. A functor is an object that implements the operator, parenthesis open, parenthesis close. That's a functor. That's what we see here. So it implements this operator, parenthesis open, parenthesis close, and that thing can take a number of parameters. And what that really means is that if I create an instance of this lock string class, then on that instance, I can write parenthesis open, give it a QString, parenthesis close, which makes it feel very much like if it was just a function that I was calling there. And what my functor here does is that in the constructor, it is taking a string that it's using as a prefix, and then in this operator parenthesis open parenthesis close, it simply print out my prefix plus the string. So down here again, my functor says lock string lock colon. It's connected to line edit text changed. And if I go up here in this line edit here and I start typing hello world, then we can see in our output down here, it says lock hello world, and so on. So for each time I type something, the text change signal is emitted. That goes into that functor that does the printout. Of course, that's a very seldom one that you do. Let's just jump to this other one. This is a standalone function. So my quit button is, its click signal is connected to my standalone function. So that's a global function that you have in there that just calls quit. So it looks like this. Yeah, well, it quit the application. Again, this is not something that you'll do very often. It's not like you want to connect all your signals to standalone functions, but hey, you can do it. The last one, however, is one that you will likely do more often. So here I have a connect, my press me buttons, pressed signal goes into this Lambda expression where it set the text to release me. And when it's released, then it goes into another Lambda expression that says press me. And let's just run the example again so you can see what it looks like. Press me. Now you can see the text changed to release me. I still hold down the mouse button. Now I release it. Now I press it. now I release it, now I press it, now I release it. So that's an example of a Lambda expression connected there. Jesper, does that mean that we can skip all our, okay, I already gave that away. Yes, you should not write all of your slots in Lambda expressions going forward. For the first reason is that if you write all of your slots in Lambda expressions, then whatever goes in the body of that Lambda expression, you cannot reuse that elsewhere. It might be that you wanted to call that function somewhere else. Second, where do I write those connection statements? Very likely in my constructor of whatever my class is doing. And now you have changed your constructor into being 5,000 lines of code of 10 Lambda expressions that each have 400 lines of code in them. That's likely not going to be a very good design for your code. You'd rather have those 10 long Lambda expressions in separate functions that had a good name that told what are we going to do here, and so on. There's a tiny little problem with Lambda expressions that I'm going to show you now. So if you see here, I got a second window. It's a QLabel. It is sized and word wrapped and whatnot, and then it has this set attribute Qt colon colon WA underscore delete on close. What this means is that whenever I close that window, Qt will actually notify and go and delete the object. So that's a nice little facility of Qt in the widget world, that you can have your top level window. They own all of the content of those windows using the parent-child relationship. And you say Qt, I cannot remember that, you say Qt colon colon WA underscore delete on close. And then whenever the top level windows is closed, it will be deleted. All the children will be deleted. But I'm using that feature now to make sure that that window is explicit closed, because that will show you a problem that you often will face when you are working with Lambda expressions. See, I set up a new Lambda expression here from the press me button. Whenever it's clicked, it goes into this Lambda expression here. It takes the second window. That's this second window we have there. It takes that as a closure. And then it's on that second window, it's called SetText. After all, the second window is just a QLabel. SetText with whatever text we had in there, and then button clicked. We go out here again and see the two windows. You can see press me, press me, press me. And over here, it updates with button clicked. Okay, I'm done with this window. I'll close it. Remember, I closed the top level window due to the Qt colon colon, whatever, I cannot remember. It has now been deleted. And now when I click, what will happen? Busy cursor. And on my standard output, it says, the program has unexpectedly finished. That's, of course, a total lie, because I did expect it to finish. Well, it crashed. And why did it crash? It crashed because that my Lambda expression in here, from here to here, that Lambda expression was still referencing second window, which is now a dangling pointer. And those, when you reference them, has that tendency of crashing. Just gave me a shock, Jesper, there. I just need to go to get my... Are you saying to me that when I connect a signal to a slot that I need to be careful to disconnect if my slot is going out of services, because otherwise my application is going to crash? Who wants to use this kind of crappy software? Like, calm down. Yeah, get your breath under control. That's not what I'm telling you. If you are just doing one of those that takes four fingers, the signal, the slot, well, the... Who's emitting the signal, which signal, who's implementing the slot and which slot, either the macro based or the other one, you're all fine. Once that ring finger here, once that one goes out of service, it will, as part of its destruction, it's a QObject after all, as part of its destruction, it'll go to Qt and say, you know what, I was just killed. If you happen to know anybody connected to me, can you please take those connections down, because I will not be around for much more. However, for our signal slot connection, where the slot part is done with a lambda, Qt has no chance to detect that. The lambda expression is still a perfectly valid expression, and Qt have no way of actually seeing that inside that lambda expression, we are referring an object that has gone out of scope. However, that is a problem that we've been facing for years. And at some point, somebody came around and said, why don't we just add that missing, what was it? That missing third finger here, namely who is implementing the slot. People like, adding who's implementing a slot is a lambda expression, you know, right? Well, let's simulate that it's who is implementing that slot. And that's what it looks like when I do like this. So first parameter, second parameter, and then I would add a third parameter saying who is implementing the slot. That is second window. Of course, it's not implementing any slot, it's a lambda expression, but it tells the connect statement, or the connect statement tells Qt, if you happen to hear that second window is being deleted, can you please take down this lambda, or this signal slot connection to a lambda expression? And that's what we'll see here. If I run it again, we'll notice that works just fine. Now I close that window and I continue, it doesn't crash anymore. Oh yes, but does that mean that you can do like a list of things here? Whoops, that you can do, keyboard error again, that you can do a list of things here. So you could have second window and third object and bar and boo and whatnot. No, that's not what it means. It's just a special case for that one special case where we connect to just a lambda expression that uses just one object. Because one of the things that you often do with lambda expressions in Qt is that you have a signal, it brings out a qstring. You want to connect that to a slot that takes an integer. But hey, qstring to an integer, you cannot do that conversion in your signal slot connection. But what you can do is that you connect your signal that brings out the qstring, then in a lambda expression, you convert that qstring to a number, using qstring colon colon to int. Now you have an integer and you call that function on that object with that. And there, the third parameter of slot, who is implementing that slot, is just perfect. That's it. We've seen lambda expressions and signal slot connections. I could have gone on for an hour telling you about lambda expressions in general, but that would be slightly beyond this training here. In the next video, I'm going to show you how you implement your own signals and your own slots. Because had the story ended with this video and said, hey, you can take these Lego bricks out of your Lego box that, and they happen to be coming from Qt and you can connect them, that would have been somewhat boring. No, the real power is when you have something that emits a signal and you can implement a slot that listens to that. So until next time, do subscribe to our channel and all that stuff. See you and have a great day. We'll be right back.